Today I want to talk to you about fake Kachinas. I see this all the time, and this is a prime example of a doll that's supposedly a 1920s doll. In fact, if you look right here, it says Old Kachina, Hamus Kachina, 1920s, but it clearly is not. And some of the things that you can look at on this doll, one of the things, they've tried to make it like a 20s doll, right? You can see how the hands are close to the belly. These are what we call the belly warmers. And when it's very early, they'll start early, like 1900, turn of the century, and the hands kind of go out. In fact, you would think if you saw something like that, it might even be an earlier doll. But everything's wrong about this doll. The colors of the green are wrong. That's a vegetal paint that should be on. They're not like this color. And if you look at the tabletta, you'll see a lot of different things. This is the tabletta part. One, look at the cotton. It's white. It shouldn't be white. It should be yellow over time. If this is a 100-year-old doll, that should be yellow. And if you look right here, they've broken the tabletta to make it look old, like it had damage. But if you look right here, you'll see an area that is the pine. This is actually probably pine wood, which should be cottonwood. And there is white to it. It would oxidize over time if it had been broken and repaired, especially if it was broken or impaired at that time. Now you could say, oh, well, maybe this was done later. Well, it's throughout the doll. They did it up here and here and here. Even this, which they tried to use an older piece of cotton twine, still isn't old enough. That's just some of the issues you're going to see. One is the wood is wrong. This part is cottonwood. They got that right, but they just used an old, a very old piece of cottonwood. In fact, you can see the beetle marks that are in the cottonwood. So they've got an old piece of cottonwood root that already had distress. You can see it around here as well. And a Hopi doll is not going to have that. If they're really making it at the time, they're going to use a nice piece of cottonwood that they could use the root, and it's not going to be distressed like this. The doll won't stand. That's also another thing. And then if you look right at the kilt, you'll see where it's all worn away with sandpaper. That's, you can even see the grooves where the sandpaper was. So they tried to distress it to make it look like it's old. So when you see a doll like this, you want to look at the front, the back, you want to look at all the colors, the design, the face on this is wrong as well. Also, these are new feathers, which you wouldn't expect. These are quail feathers. They would be different, and they would have been, would look a lot different than that. So when you see an old doll that's supposed to be old, you better look for any kind of distress that's real, where hands would touch it. You also better look and see if the colors are right, if the design is right. If you don't know what it is, don't buy it. Only buy from dealers who know what they're doing or auction houses that are reputable. Because otherwise, you're going to end up with this, a Hopi Kachina doll that isn't even Hopi.
Medicine Man Gallery, located for over 26 years in Tucson, Arizona, specializing in antique Native American art, early Western art, including the famed Maynard Dixon, as well as modern art. You can find everything online at medicinemangallery.com. There's over 6,000 objects to select from. Also, the Charles Bloom Murder Mystery Series, written by yours truly, me, Mark Sublett. There's 6 books in the series, and they follow the protagonist Charles Bloom through all the intrigue of the art world set in Santa Fe and the Navajo Nation. These can be found on Audible, eBooks, Amazon, and of course, the gallery at medicinemangallery.com.